Hello, welcome again. We are solving some questions of theorem which in the topic is vibration. Question number 55 is, choose the incorrect statement in case of force damped vibration. Option A, damping force leads the spring force by 90 degrees. B, inertia force leads the spring force by 180 degrees. C, damping force lags the inertia force by 90 degrees. D, inertia force leads the spring force by 90 degrees. This is the equation of force vibration, that is mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx plus is equal to f dot sine omega t. Here the force is varying with sine and omega t is your angle. Okay. So here the maximum amplitude of the force is f naught. So let us the displacement equation is like this, and it is lagging the force by angle phi. So whenever the maximum amplitude of force occurs after after phi angle, the maximum amplitude of x occurs. So x is your x capital X sine omega t minus phi. So differentiating, that will be x omega sine differentiating it will be x capital X sin omega t minus pi is it, cos omega t minus pi multiplied by omega, and this will be your x omega sin pi by 2 plus omega t minus pi. It means cos omega t minus pi can be written as because cos is because sin is positive in second quadrant, so this is in second quadrant, this is in first quadrant, so in terms of sin it can be written as sin pi by 2 plus omega t minus pi. So this will ultimately lead to cos omega t minus pi. Okay. So that thing and that this is our thing. So now we have generated a velocity equation in terms like that. Okay. So in terms of sign. So it means that the velocity is leading the displacement by pi by 2. Similarly, again differentiating, we can find the equation of acceleration, so that is minus x omega square. Again, this is this force differentiation will be minus sine, so minus we have taken, so that will be sine omega t minus pi, or will be x omega square sine pi omega t minus pi will be omega minus sine. So it means it is also leading the leading of displacement by pi. So it means the damping force, which is directly proportional to velocity, is leading the spring force by 90 degrees. Okay. And inertia force, which is directly proportional to acceleration, okay, so is leading the spring force by 180 degrees. So, answer is option D, because inertia force leading the spring force by 180 degrees. So, it is in the option D, it is given that it leads the spring force by 90 degrees. So, that is wrong. So as damping force is leading the inertia force by 90 degrees, so it will inertia force is leading the spring force by 180 degrees, so damping force is also leading. Damping force lags the spring force by 90 degrees. So first three statements are correct, because if you take the spring force first, then the damping force leads the spring force by 90 degrees, and the inertia force leads the damping force by 90 degrees, or inertia force leads the spring force by 180 degrees. So last one is incorrect, because here it is given that inertia force leads the spring force by 90 degrees. That is wrong. The actual is the inertia force leads the spring force by 180 degrees. That is correct. So answer is option B.